Bar Italia was opened in the winter of 1949, and it was opened by my grandparents, Lou and Caterina Pelledri.
It's a great place, isn't it? You know, it's got a great ambience about it. It's, everybody, I think everybody in the world knows Bar Italia. You talk about Soho, everybody knows Bar Italia.
It's like, you know, this is the sort of bar you get in Italy, you know, it's authentic.
Just by the Colosseum, you'd think it'd been lifted from there to here. I mean, it's just...
Because it's got that old school feel. It still feels like you're in a time capsule. You could easily be in the late 40s, early 50s.
Very little has changed. The formica is still, the red and white formica is still original. This floor has an interesting story to tell because that's completely original as well.
Great, lively, busy atmosphere. And I think they've done a great, you know, the way they've kept it.
They've kept the character of the place, which is fantastic.
We haven't deviated too far from where we first started, and that's serving good coffee, the best coffee, coffee possible, to discerning customers who really know about coffee.
Yeah, I mean, it is a landmark, but also it is still the best place to get coffee. There's no question, you know.
But I can honestly say it is the best cappuccino I've ever drunk.
Our coffee machine is another icon here. That's been in here for 40 years, and it's still working as well as the day we bought it.
And the food is always really good. Good, tasty food, fresh, very authentic to more what you would get in an Italian cafe.
Yeah, a few years ago, I bought Vinny Pazienza here when he fought Harold Graham for the WBC International Super Middleweight Championship at Wembley.
In the 80s, when we kind of got into, me and my friends kind of got into the absolute beginners coffee culture. And of course, Ronnie Scott's is across the road as well.
And we came here on a Saturday morning, we had a great time, and I have many happy memories here of early summer mornings with the late, great Denny Mancini. So, I've got some, late nights, early mornings.
I really like the decor. I really like all the photos they have.
This little gallery was put together by my sister Veronica and Paola. They thought that, you know, the customers had so much input to Bar Italia, and they're here every day of the week.
Well, I mean, I think I do use the place every day. I think this whole thing was... all these portraits were here to show people that are very familiar and well-known in the Bar Italia, particularly.
So there's a sense of history, you know, in this place, which kind of taps into Soho, which I'm a big fan of.
Must say, I'm a bit serious in that one. Good for me, even when I'm coming home. If I'm coming home late at night and I want to just wind down, I'll pop in here, even if it's just for a quick coffee and a chat. 2 or 3 in the morning, and the chat to whoever.
My father used to come here at night, and his philosophy was, you never really close until the last customer wants to leave. And then we found out the customers were leaving later and later.
But the great thing about it, it's being 24 hours, so it's always there. You can always, at some point, you can, if things have got a little bit out of hand, there is some resting place you can get. It's like a church. You can come in and sort of, calm down and then say a few cappuccinos and go back out into the big wide world.
In here, I've always just late nights, drinks, meeting people, meeting some nice girls, funny enough, late at night for a quick coffee and a chat and then getting to know them and everything. It's always been interesting for that, just coming out.
You've got theatre, you're in the heart of theatre land, and people don't necessarily want to go straight home once they come out of the theatre. They want to come for a coffee, sit down in the outside possibly, talk to their friends, people watch, because this is a very special place to watch people.
You know, cleaning the shop windows and getting everything ready for the day, and I sort of like sitting out there and just watching, you know, the preparation for another day in Soho.
Actually seeing Italy win 2 World Cups here, I think that's something that maybe one day my children, I'd love them to see it and experience what we went through. It was just absolutely amazing.
You know, I've come in here sometimes when there's been the Italian games on, and the atmosphere is absolutely unbelievable.
on the downside is when Italy were in the final, the place was so packed up without air conditioning, the television actually stopped halfway through the game. And that was an absolute nightmare because everybody seemed to think it was my fault. And I had about 150 screaming Italians calling me every name under the sun and swearing at me. And really, it wasn't my fault, but I was lucky enough to hire, or just grab a television from the restaurant next door, which was Bianchi's. And we put it all back in and set it all up, and it started working. And that was a fantastic event, watching Italy win. And that went from a really bad story to a great story. This is a venue where you get celebrities on one hand, and when I first started working here, you used to have gangsters on the other.
I used to work for Lennox Lewis's company, and we were in Gainsborough House in Oxford Street. And this is where we used to have all our meetings in here. You know, we'd have our breakfast meetings in here and our lunch meetings next door in Little Italy.
It's always been a good meeting point. I always seem to end up down this end of the bar having meetings with gentlemen from South London.
And our evening meetings will be done between the two, so it's...
Oh, definitely, it's a classic place to meet people, especially if you want to meet outside and chill and on a summer's day, you sit outside and you relax.
You know, everybody had a nickname. There was Russian Bill, there was Joe the Crow, there was French Lou. You know, you had to have a nickname. That was part and parcel of being in Soho, you know, in the early 60s, 70s, and you know, then touching on the 80s. But, you know, I think that's the other thing with Bar Italia, is that it doesn't matter how famous you are and how important you really are, you can just come in here, you won't get hassled, you won't get nagged, you won't be asked for too many autographs or photos, and you can just blend in and be in a little part of Italy, right in the heart of Soho.
I'd much rather meet someone like this than a pub. So every time when I'm making an arrangement to meet somebody, any time of the day, I'll always, normally, 9 times out of 10, I would say I'll just meet at the Bar Italia.
You know, we're still trying to hold on. I'd like to think that one day my children and my brother's children will want to take on a fantastic opportunity of running possibly the most famous cafe in, well, would I say, in Europe, definitely in England.